Good afternoon. He's been one of Australia's most wanted for nearly a quarter of a century, and police have just 3 months to find him. James Dalamangas is almost certainly hiding out in Greece, having fled there after the stabbing death of a young Sydney father. The victim's family knows their legal window is closing. Here's Grace Fitzgibbon.
Well, police have spent more than two decades trying to track down Australian fugitive James Dalamangas, and as the clock ticks louder, they need your help. Dalamangas is wanted over the stabbing murder of Sydney father George Giannopoulos at a Belmore nightclub in April 1999. Dalamangas fast fled to Greece, and detectives have been searching for him ever since. Today, George's sister stepped up to the microphones, issuing a heartfelt plea for justice.
Please help my family and I to have some sort of closure with the arrest of the man who we believe murdered my brother George Giannopoulos.
There is solid evidence to suggest Dalamangas is living and working in Greece. Greek authorities have been assisting with the manhunt, but this April marks the 25th anniversary of the crime, and the statute of limitations will end.
Time is now of the essence.
Police have generated an image of what they believe Dalamangas would look like today, and they're offering a $200,000 reward for anyone with even the slightest piece of information that could lead them to the fugitive.
All we need to know is where he is, and we'll do the rest.
Police delivered their appeal in both English and Greek today. They say that $200,000 reward can be claimed by anyone living in Australia or Greece.
A family in Sydney's south has been targeted by arsonists. It's the second attack there in just 3 days. Four adults and two children were inside the Hurstville home when their luxury car was set alight. Police are hunting those responsible.
We believe there's up to two. Okay. There may also be another vehicle involved. As I said, look, at the moment we're continuing our canvas to try and find more witnesses, more CCTV.
The vehicle was destroyed and the home was also badly damaged. Windows exploded as the blaze took hold. The loss of an Alaska Airlines panel mid-flight was initially described as a freak accident, but evidence now could suggest it was an accident waiting to happen. Loose bolts have been found on similar Boeing planes. Authorities have also recovered the missing panel from an Oregon home.
Boeing's problems are stacking up fast. Almost 200 of its planes were grounded in the immediate aftermath of this mishap seen around the world. And now, loose bolts and other installation issues have been picked up in inspections. America's Transport Safety Bureau has recovered the missing piece of the plane, a 28-kilogram door plug discovered in an Oregon backyard. The plug is now on its way to a lab in Washington, where it will be closely examined. As investigators try to determine how and why the Alaska Airlines flight suffered a decompression explosion at 16,000 feet.
Alaska 1282, we just requested we declared emergency. We needed to send them to 10,000.
While thankfully no one was sitting in the seat closest to the door, seats within meters of it were left twisted and bent. The headrests and cushions were sucked out of the plane, along with clothing and mobile phones. Nicholas Holt was on board.
I was starting to text my girlfriend, my mom, my other loved ones, and didn't know if I was going to make it on the other side. It was a lot of intense emotions.
The Transport Safety Bureau now says on three previous flights, pressurization warning lights lit up on the plane. Yet Alaskan Airlines only restricted it from flying over water until technicians could evaluate the problem.
It's early, but should Alaska have grounded the plane back then?
Certainly it should have been a warning sign to them, just on safety overall.
Boeing's CEO has called a company-wide meeting tomorrow to focus on safety. Zoe Martin, 7 News.
Black Friday sales have boosted our economy. New retail figures show Australians spent $36.5 billion in November. That represents a 2% jump from October. Economists say the cost of living is forcing Australian shoppers to become more savvy. Josh Martin explains.
Good afternoon. Inflation is causing Australians to be frugal. Many waited until Black Friday and the discounts on offer before opening their wallets. Spending on household goods was up 7.5% from October to November. That's everything from furniture to white goods and electronics. Department stores also had increased trade in what is the nation's new favourite sales event.
People are just being very frugal with their budgeting at the moment waiting for the opportune time to make those big ticket purchases.
Habits are changing and November is now a big month for retail trade. $36.5 billion spent nationally, up 2% from October. Shopping centre car parks at capacity, escalators full and plenty of clicking.
Admittedly, I did do a lot of my shopping online.
Consumers didn't splurge at cafes and restaurants. Trade was only up 0.4% month to month in what is normally a busier period.
People spending more small amounts this year than last year.
Definitely dinners have been cut.
Economists say the better than expected retail trade figures shouldn't push up inflation, which is sitting at 4.9% as items were on sale. The Reserve Bank, though, will be watching closely when monthly inflation data comes out tomorrow.
We're making some welcome and encouraging progress in the fight against inflation, but that fight's not over yet.
A majority of economists are predicting interest rates to stay on hold until coming down at the end of the year.
At least 21 people have been injured in an explosion at a historic Texas hotel. Emergency crews scrambled to rescue people trapped in a basement in the minutes after the blast. It's believed to have been caused by natural gas. The hotel is being renovated right now. One person was critically injured and four others are in a serious condition. Well, from the turf to the surf, the Magic Millions was off and racing this morning in a flurry of hooves on the sands of Surfers Paradise. The carnival launch attracted fans and even royalty. Amanda Rabate was there.
Well, this is a yearly tradition and a spectacular one. A dozen horses galloping down the sand, watched on by a crowd of thousands who have come from across the country for the Magic Millions Carnival, this being one of the favourite and, of course, free events on the calendar.
I'm just trying to convince the Katie to let me ride
next year.
Look, what could possibly go wrong? Yes. So everyone remembers the horses on the Autobahn, as the Germans said last year after this event.
Well, there are fewer horses this year and extra barriers to prevent any of the thoroughbreds doing the bolt like we saw last year. Royal Zara Tyndall saddled up alongside international polo star Nacho Figueres and Billy Slater.
This is pretty unique to the Gold Coast, you know, racing up the beach. It's incredible.
The all-important barrier draw took place by the beach for Saturday's race day, the richest race day in Magic Millions history, a record 11 races this year and a prize purse of $14.25 million. Gay Waterhouse trained Stallboy is favourite.
10. Alan's unhappy.
And then it was time for the yearling auctions to kick off. We're talking hundreds of millions of dollars changing hands over the next week. More than 1,000 thoroughbreds going under the hammer for a chance to race back here at the Millions next year. It is a huge week and of course you'll see all of the highlights and the action from the track on Saturday right here on 7.